Hey guys, Isaac Eicher here. This video is going to be all about salsa music on the mandolin and the style that I've created that allows me to groove and jam with the congas and bass and other percussion instruments that are common in a salsa setting. This might be an unfamiliar rhythm to many of you, so I'm going to break it down and then I'm going to show you some different patterns, different chord progressions that are fun to jam on. For our play-along track today, we're using a product created by my friend Alex Rivas, which is called Salsa Loops, and that's available for download on his website. The link is going to be in the description below. That's basically a library of samples of different percussion instruments that are common in salsa music that allows you to create your own backing track. And the bass on the backing tracks today was done by my friend Edwin Canito Garcia, who I know from Tulsa, who's helped me over the years better understand how to play on this music. And he's been kind enough to send over some different chord progressions that I'm going to jam along with today. Before we jump into the backing tracks, let me show you a little bit of the picking pattern. And we're just going to do this over a basic C chord. And the thing to keep in mind here is that we're really grooving along with the tumbao of the congas and lining up with the bass and when they hit. What they're doing and what we're copying is we're hitting on the and of two and on four and four and. And sometimes I alter this and sometimes I'm specifically lining up with the bass and other times I'm really mimicking what the congas are doing. So the first thing we're going to look at is this picking pattern that's my standard montuno groove on the mandolin that interlocks with the congas and the bass. And we're going to be looking at the key of C. And here's the transcription. And you can see that a montuno is really just an arpeggio that I'm picking through and explaining kind of what the chord is without playing a chord. I'm just playing the arpeggio. This is a lot of eighth notes. And so the important aspect is where are we tying and not picking, where are we holding out notes? So you'll see on the and of two and the and of four, we are tying over to the next eighth note. And what that means for our picking pattern, we're gonna really maintain a down, up pick stroke pattern. Keep in mind, if we're tying over and avoiding the front side of the beat, then we come back in and play on the and, then we're going to come back with a upstroke. So this is what this one sounds like. This is just over the key of C. Now, you'll notice that on the second measure, on the four, I'm playing a quarter note, and that really sets me up to play on the downbeat of the next measure. Because if you notice, between the first measure and the second measure, I'm avoiding the one of the second measure. That's because I'm tying from the and of four to the first beat of the second measure, and I'm coming back on the and of one with that upstroke. So you could actually do that every measure, just keeping the same rhythm figure of the first measure and just repeating that indefinitely, and that would sound like this. And that's really what the congas are doing. They're playing on the four and four and of every measure with those low tones. So that's a way that we can interlock with the congas, and we can do that and it sounds good, but it also sounds good to play on the four and lock in with the bass. And in that way, it also allows us to play on the one of the next measure, what would be the first measure in a two bar phrase. Now let's hear what this sounds like with our backing track. Now we're going to change it up and we're going to play adding in a G chord. So we're going back and forth from a C to a G chord. And that sounds like this. And really, I'm using the same pattern as I did before, but now I'm just adding in some different arpeggios to create this chord progression. Thank you. Now let's change keys, and we're going to do a pattern that I really like that developed, really stealing it from the Buena Vista Social Club recordings on El Cuarto de Tula. And I just took a montuno that they do in a minor key, and I just made it major and adapted that to the mandolin. So this one sounds really nice, which works over D and A. And so here's what I'm doing. I'm using three strings, and I'm using my fourth finger on the D here to get that tone to ring out. So now we're going to change keys again, and we're going to go to C minor, and we're going to do this chord progression that's actually a montuno that I use on a tune that my wife wrote that we play. This is going to be four chord changes, and we're going from C minor to an A flat major, and then we're going to go to an F minor, and then I'm going to play a G in several different ways. I can do it like this. Like a G augmented, or so I'm using the same picking pattern, and this is what this one sounds like.